and you will know my name is the Lord when I lay my vengeance upon thee.
Better tell him to shut the fuck up. He's getting on my nerves.
Marvin. Marvin. Marvin!
I'd knock that shit off if I was you.
Die, you motherfucker!
The Vickers Mk. 7 is a British Rank 6 BR 9.7 failed abortion of a tank that turned out to only be useful to fat tier boosts like myself 30 years later on a Russian computer game. This Frankenstein's monster is the result of an intense orgy of a Vickers Mk. 4 turret and a Leopard 2 hull, with the intention to create a Challenger 1 replacement baby, only for the real fucking to be done by the British government, who cancelled it, because local jobs for local people. Furthermore, because Germans are peace-loving fucks, and banned the use of their military equipment in tense regions of the world, it couldn't even be sold to Arabs with nothing better to do with their time, but enslave engines, and screech about Israel or each other, and as such only one of these tanks was built. However, its design strongly influenced the Challenger 2. In War Thunder, this is perhaps the last good point of the British 3 before the pain of the Challenger getting raped by Abrams, Leopards and T-80s. So, how's the maneuverability? Well, if you listen even half as well as boomers listen to whatever a tarded newspaper has to say, you'll recall that it has a Leopard 2 hull. So we will move on. Okay, seriously, this thing has a car 500, 1500 horsepower engine from a 2A4 which can propel all 55 tons of tank to a maximum speed of 40 miles per hour. But it will accelerate very quickly, and go nearly as fast in reverse, so if it's fast, the armor must be lacking, right? While literally on the surface the Vickers has about 80 mil of hull armor and similar on the turret, it is blessed with years of big brain ingenuity that resulted in the Chobham composite armor packs. As such, it has an effective 300 millimeters of kinetic protection on the hull, and anywhere from 300 to 700 on the turret cheeks, and against chemical weapons it has around 600 mil on both the upper plate and the turret cheeks. However, if you think you are invulnerable like Britain before World War 1, you are an idiot, as the tank has three main weak spots. The lower plate has only 300 mil of Chobham, meaning it is weaker against chemical rounds and looks like a kebab after a 3 AM night out to enemy kinetic rounds. The turret cheeks don't have Chobham, but generally the breech will absorb shots, but you can lose Tommies if you're not careful, and unbelievably it has fucking 10 mm of side armor.
Nope.
Since apparently nutters with RPGs didn't exist then. Essentially, your armor will be amazing held down, and at ranges this was literally what NATO tanks were meant to do. But if you're lucky, you can absorb a shot or two at close range, and since the turret is actually bigger than Wales, I find that only a crewman or two dies at a time. So we've covered the armor. What about the armament? The Mk. 7 has the same L11A5 rifled cannon from the Challenger 1. Although gauge and please, it was offered to buyers with smoothbore guns too. So 80 GMs for Brits please. This gun is like a fried breakfast, sturdy, reliable and made by a greasy man in England, and also contains sausages. The best round is the L23A1 Butcher's Own Devonshire Pork product with nearly 400 mm of pen at 1 km, which is more than enough to use it as a sniper rifle, to fuck with the weaker spots of higher tier MBTs and anything below it, and the stock L23 Sainsbury's Essential Sausage is frankly just as able. Also, since your loader stopped the wacky backy and moved on to speed, he loads the 3-stage ammunition in 7 seconds flat, which while not quite as good as Robot Ivan in the T-80s, is pretty damn good. So, how do you play the embodiment of British nationalism? To start, load around 20 rounds of Butcher's Own to empty out as many sausage freezers as possible, so more tea can be stacked as side armor, and mostly tell Hesh to eat shit. You are Seymour higher in tank form, and having gone to private school, so you do not charge blindly in. But you catch idiot Swedish tankers doing exactly that. You pick off easy tanks, and put shots downrange onto Russian MBTs, making use of your good maneuverability and strong armor to hide, shoot and scoot. Unlike the Warrior, however, this does come with an optional manliness option, and if you feel suicidal enough, go for it. Your own reactions matter more, as killing the enemy gunner is your main aim, before screwing up the rest of the tank worse than the EU seems to be screwing up coronavirus. Also, don't forget to use your real-life dart mode to spot smoking hot leopards out in the open with their lidar hosen down, and remind them that 2 World Wars and 1 World Cup. Now you have some inkling of how to play. We will move on to the upgrades, so just like the UK, you can add more bits and pieces on. Firstly, take parts and FPE to make sure Steve the mechanic follows you around, and you don't end up like cheaply constructed tower blocks, followed by cool shades for your gunner to spot when it stops fucking raining. Then 20 sterling duels or a 30g of amber leaf, elevation mechanism because it takes so damn long to move its dung around, and crew replenishment to offset military funding cuts. Finally, get the high quality pork and the laser rangefinder, and after that do whatever the fuck you please. Now, when it comes to crew, they should probably be quite skilled by now after the infuriating grind, but if you're basically Bloomberg splashing the cash, I got you my homie. For your driver, take tank driving, since you have 6 points on your license from crashing your mum's Corsa, followed by vitality and repair, to not be a burden on the NHS, and make sure she doesn't notice the damage. For your gunner, take targeting and range finding, since shooting is probably part of your state allocated exercise time, and vitality and repair again for when some bullshit continental pens you. For your commander, take leadership to ensure your 80 seat majority, and once again, vitality and repair for when shit's fucked, and for your loader, take weapon reloading so he doesn't drop the propellant on his foot again. Then do whatever you want for shits and giggles. By following these simple steps, you will find that this is the correct way to play the Vickers Mk 7. Now don't go out there, and do remain indoors to flatten the curve.